children, today we are going to learn English grammar. So, in English grammar, we are going to learn a relative clause. What is relative clause? Here you see definition. A subordinate clause which does the work of an adjective and qualifies a noun or pronoun in the main clause is called a relative clause. Again you see. Subordinate clause which does the work of an adjective and qualifies a noun or pronoun. The main clause is called relative clause. Here you see one example. Umbrella which has a broken handle is mine. Underlined part is has a broken handle. Here it is relative clause. This relative clause defines the noun umbrella. It gives information about the umbrella. So that's why it is called relative clause. This relative clause divided into two clauses. Relative clause divided into two clauses. Defining relative clause and non-defining relative clause. Defining relative clause and a non-defining clause. Now we are going to learn a defining relative clause. What is the defining relative clause? Here is the definition. A relative clause which defines or gives essential information about a noun or a pronoun is called defining relative clause. A relative clause which defines or gives essential information about a noun or a pronoun is called defining relative clause. You see example. The man who takes away another man's freedom is a prisoner. In this sentence, the underlined part is a relative clause. Who takes away another man's freedom? This relative clause defines about the man, about the noun, defines about the noun, and it is giving essential information. This underlined part, this relative clause is essential here. Without this relative clause, we can't understand fully. We can't understand the sentence. The man is a prisoner. Who is this man? So here, with the help of this relative clause, we understand the man. Oh, this is who takes away another man's freedom. That man is prisoner. And you see second one. The silk sarees, which are made in Benaras, are popular all over the world. Here you see underlined part. This is relative clause. They are made in Benaras. The silk sarees is now here. Relative clause giving essential information about the silk sarees. Without this essential information, we can't understand about silk sarees fully. That's why it is called defining relative clause. Defining relative clause means relative clause gives essential information about the noun or pronoun. Relative clause which defines or gives information about noun or pronoun is called defining relative clause. Now you see some about the defining relative clause. Defining relative clause starts with relative pronoun who or which. Here you see defining relative clause. In defining relative clause, relative clause starts with who or which. These are relative pronouns. Who and which are relative pronouns. If noun in the main clause is person, we use relative pronoun. Here you see the man. The man is noun. The man is person. So that's why we use who. If it is a thing, we use relative pronoun which. Silk saris is which. Silk saris is saris are things. So we used which. We can use relative pronoun that instead of who and which. Defining relative clause, we use who and which relative as relative pronouns. But we can remove also. We can remove and we can use that also here. You see, the man that takes away another man's freedom is a prisoner. Here, we removed who and we used that. And next step, the silk sarees that are made in Benaras are popular all over the world. Here, we removed which and we used that here. We can use the relative pronoun that instead of who and it in defining relative class. So now, a relative class whose extra information about noun or pronoun in the main class is called non-defining relative. Difference between relative class, defining relative class and non-defining relative class is relative class which gives essential information, it is defining relative class. Relative class which gives extra information, that is non-defining. Here you see Napoleon, who won the French honor, died at St. Helena. Here you see the underlined part, relative class. This relative class is giving information about the Napoleon, but it is not essential information. Is only extra information only. We can add this here, or we can remove also. If we remove also, we understand the sentence. Napoleon died at St. Helena. It is giving extra information only. Who is this Napoleon? Who won the French honor? Second sentence. Dick, who was teased and bullied, had an electric wheelchair. Already we knew Nick. We remove this class, underlined part. It had a wheelchair for mobility. You already think. But here we are giving extra information. Who was teased and bullied? Extra information. So these two are belongs to non-defining relative class. In non-defining relative class, we use relative pronouns who to the persons and which to the things. We use relative pronouns in this also, in non-defining relative class also. So in the same way, defining relative class, we use to the persons. We use relative pronouns who to the persons. We use which to the things. We don't use that instead of who and which. Defining relative class, we use that also instead of who and which. But this non-defining relative class, we don't use that. In non-differing relative class, we use commas before and after the relative class. Example, you see, Suresh, who is our school leader, has left the school just now. Here, who is our school leader is non-differing relative class. We use here commas before and after the non-differing relative class. We don't use commas in defining relative class. For example, the express which is going to New Delhi has just arrived. Here you see, this underlined part, defining relative class. We don't use commas here. It is time for homework. Write two examples to each class, defining relative class and non-defining class. Okay? Thank you, friends. Thank you very much. Okay. Bye. We meet again.